How do you take a bite when your own teeth are in the way? Imagine an animal whose most famous feature, its primary weapon, is also its greatest liability. A pair of knives, 7 inches long, permanently attached to your face. Knives so specialized, so extreme, that a single wrong move, a twist, a struggle, a bite into bone could snap them like a porcelain vase. This is not a monster from a fantasy novel. This was a real predator. And when you hear saber-toothed cat, you probably picture a long-fanged tiger. But you'd be completely wrong. The animal that truly dominated the Ice Age was something far stranger, far more specialized, and ultimately, far more terrifying. This was Smilodon, and its entire life was a high-stakes evolutionary gamble, built around a weapon that almost seems impossible. Today, we are sinking our teeth into the bizarre biology of the most famous saber-toothed cat of all. What was this animal really like? How did it hunt with those absurd fangs? And why did evolution build a killing machine that was seemingly designed to break? Welcome to the Pleistocene, the Ice Age. This is the world Smilodon ruled for over 2 million years, prowling ecosystems from the cold plains of North America all the way down to Peru. Now, first things first, let's clear up the biggest misconception. The saber-toothed tiger, it doesn't exist. Smilodon was not a tiger. In fact, it's not closely related to any cat alive today. It belonged to an entirely extinct subfamily called the Metrorodons, the dagger-toothed cats. This was a separate evolutionary experiment, a different way to be a cat, and Smilodon was the terrifying climax of that experiment. There were three main species. The relatively smaller Smilodon gracilis, the absolute unit, Smilodon populator from South America, which could weigh up to 900 pounds bigger than the burliest modern lion or tiger. But the most famous, the one pulled by the thousands from the Labrie tar pits in Los Angeles, is the one we'll focus on, Smilodon. And fatalis, meaning deadly dash, was, well, weird is an understatement. If you ignore the head for a second and just look at the body, it's still bizarre. When paleontologists first assembled its skeleton, they were baffled. Its proportions are all wrong for a cat. Forget the sleek, graceful build of a cheetah or even a tiger. Smilodon was built like a grizzly bear. Its front legs were massively powerful, far more robust than its hind legs. Its neck vertebrae were thick and dense, anchoring enormous muscles. Its lumbar region, the lower back, was short and stiff, not flexible like a modern runner's. And its tail, it was a laughable, bobtailed stump. This animal couldn't chase anything. It had all the grace of a runaway refrigerator. This anatomy paints a chilling picture. Smilodon was not a pursuit predator. It was an evolutionary statement. I do not run, I end things. It was a specialist in ambush. An overwhelming force, its entire body was designed for one purpose, to get its paws on a victim and pin it down. Its massive forelimbs weren't for running. They were grappling hooks, armed with non-retractable claws, designed to wrestle giant Ice Age prey like ancient bison or giant ground sloths into submission. Only after the prey was immobilized, held fast in a predator's equivalent of a bear hug, did the real weirdness come into play. Okay, let's talk about the teeth. Those 7-inch, 18-centimeter canines. They are serrated, like a steak knife, and flattened from side to side. But here's the paradox we started with. They were also incredibly fragile. They were strong front to back, perfect for slicing. But any side-to-side force, any lateral pressure, like the kind you'd get from struggling prey twisting its head, or striking a thick bone, snap. The Labrie tar pits are full of Smilodon fossils with broken fangs. This was a constant, life-threatening problem. So, how do you use a weapon that breaks half the time? Evolution's answer was just as bizarre as the teeth themselves. It completely re-engineered the cat's skull and muscles. First, the gape. A lion can open its mouth about 65 degrees. Smilodon could swing its jaw open to nearly 120 degrees. It had to, just to get its own chin out of the way of its fangs. Second, the bite force. You'd think an animal with teeth like this would have a bite like a T-Rex, right? Wrong. Studies on the skull and muscle attachments show Smilodon had a pathetically weak bite. Its bite force was less than half that of a modern lion. It couldn't crush bones. It couldn't even hold on to struggling prey with its jaws. This seems like a massive evolutionary failure. Why build a predator with a weak bite? Because Smilodon didn't bite like a lion. A lion bites to suffocate, crushing the windpipe. Smilodon couldn't do that. It would break its teeth. Remember those thick, powerful neck vertebrae? Smilodon didn't bite down. It struck down. The killing method was a carefully choreographed sequence of brutal efficiency. Step 1, the ambush. It used its massive body to burst from cover and slam into its prey. Step 2, the pin. It would wrestle the animal to the ground with those bear-like forelimbs, immobilizing it. This was the most critical part. The prey had to be still. Step 3, the bite. It would open its jaws to that impossible 120-degree angle, positioning the fangs over the softest, most vulnerable part of the prey, the throat or the belly. And then, it didn't use its jaw muscles. Instead, it anchored its lower jaw and powerfully flexed its neck, driving the twin sabers deep into the flesh with the force of its entire upper body. It was a precision strike, a canine shear bite. It didn't need crushing force. It needed slicing force, severing the carotid arteries and the jugular vein in seconds. The prey would bleed out in under a minute. This is the unbelievable evolutionary trade-off. Smilodon sacrificed bite strength, speed, and agility, all for a single, specialized high-reward kill. Its fangs were like a surgeon's scalpel, attached to a 700-pound linebacker. But this hyper-specialization left it vulnerable. If it missed and hit the prey's shoulder blade, snap. If the prey thrashed at the wrong second, snap. It was an all-or-nothing predator. This bizarre high-risk lifestyle leads us to one of the greatest mysteries in paleontology. Hidden in the black, bubbling goo of Los Angeles, the Labrie tar pits are a natural asphalt seep, and for tens of thousands of years, they've been a perfect, gruesome trap. An animal, maybe a young mastodon, would get stuck, crying out in distress. This was like a dinner bell for predators, and they came in droves. But when they pounced on their easy meal, they too would get stuck in the tar. Paleontologists have excavated millions of fossils from these pits, but the numbers are wrong. In a healthy ecosystem, you have lots of prey animals and very few top predators. In the tar pits, the numbers are flipped. For every one herbivore, like a bison or a horse, scientists have found 9 top predators. The pits are choked with the bones of dire wolves and, most of all, Smilodon. Over 2,000 individual Smilodon have been found. What does this tell us? Why were so many Smilodon throwing themselves into this obvious trap? The most compelling answer is as strange as the cat itself. They were social. A single Smilodon might be cautious, but if you're a member of a pack or a pride and you hear a potential meal, the sound of a struggling animal would draw the entire group. They'd all pile in, competing, and multiple members would get trapped at once. We even have fossil evidence of Smilodon living with horrific injuries. We've found skeletons with crushed pelvises, broken legs, and infected jaws injuries that would have made it impossible for a lone ambush predator to hunt. Yet, these wounds had healed. The animal lived for months, or even years, after its injury. How? The only logical way is that it was being fed. Its pride members were bringing it food, or, at the very least, protecting it at the kill site. So let's update our mental image. This isn't a lone tiger. This is a social, bob-tailed, bare-bodied creature, hunting in organized groups, cooperating to bring down 5-ton ground sloths, and caring for its wounded. This wasn't just a weird cat. This was an evolutionary experiment in social, specialized, mega-predation. For 2.5 million years, this strategy was unbelievably successful. Smilodon was the apex predator of the Americas, But the very thing that made it so dominant, its extreme specialization, was also its death sentence. Around 11,000 years ago, the Ice Age ended. The climate changed rapidly. The megafauna that Smilodon had evolved to hunt, the giant sloths, the massive bison, the horses, the camels, they all vanished. And Smilodon couldn't adapt. Think about it. Its entire body was a grappling machine for giant prey. It was too slow, too bulky, and too stiff to chase the fast, agile animals that were taking over, like deer. Its canine shear bite was useless. How do you pin down a deer? How do you deliver a precision neck strike to a small, fast-moving target? Its evolutionary gamble, which had paid off for millennia, finally failed. While more adaptable generalists, like the ancestors of modern pumas and wolves, survived and thrived, Smilodon starved. Its broken fangs and healed bones tell a story of a tough life. But its extinction tells the final, unforgiving story of evolution. Specialization can make you a king, but when the world changes, it can turn your crown into a tombstone. The saber-toothed cat is an icon, but the reality is so much weirder than we imagine. This was not a tiger. It was a 700-pound, bare-bodied, bob-tailed social predator. A creature that abandoned speed for overwhelming power. And its most famous feature, those 7-inch fangs, were so extreme they forced its entire skull to evolve around them, trading a crushing bite for a 120-degree gape, just to land one perfect, fatal slice. Smilodon is one of evolution's most dramatic lessons. It shows us that for millions of years, the right way to be a cat wasn't to be fast and sleek, but to be a bizarre, grappling brute with knives on its face. It's a reminder that in the deep past, life found solutions that seem utterly impossible to us today. So, what do you think? Is Smilodon the weirdest cat that ever lived? Or do you know of another ancient predator that's even more bizarre? Let me know in the comments below. If you're also passionate about unbelievable evolutionary stories like this, don't forget to like, subscribe to Weird Animal Evolution, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any bizarre creatures in the next video. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.